This tutorial shows how to save shapes and objects as images in PowerPoint. Hello, my name is Erin. If you've watched any of my recent tutorials, you may have noticed the shapes I use for annotations. Rather than create those shapes in my video editing software, I create them in PowerPoint and then save them as an image, which I can then upload into my videos. So today we're going to look at how to save shapes and objects as images in PowerPoint. In fact, you can save multiple shapes and objects as one image. I'll be using PowerPoint for Microsoft 365. These steps also apply to PowerPoint 2019, PowerPoint 2016, and PowerPoint 2013. We'll cover this topic for PowerPoint for Mac in a separate tutorial. Please note that the following steps assume you've already created your shape or object. We'll look at how to create and customize shapes and objects in PowerPoint in separate tutorials. To begin, select the shape or object. A shape is anything inserted with the Shape menu in the Insert tab. An object can be any of several other popular options shown in this tab, including Smart Art, an icon, a table, or a chart. If you want to include additional shapes or objects in your image, press and hold the Shift key as you make additional selections. Next, right-click your selection and select Save as Picture from the shortcut menu. Now, select the location where you want to save your image in the Save as Picture dialog box. I'm going to save my image to my desktop. You can use the default file name or enter a new file name into the File Name text box. And then select a file format in the Save as Type drop-down menu. There are many options, but the two most common file formats are JPEG and PNG, also pronounced ping. There are compression differences between these formats, but for most users, the most important difference is the fact that the PNGs, or pings, have a transparent background, while JPEGs have a white background. Finally, select the Save button. Your shape or object should now be saved in its new location. I saved mine on my desktop, so if I move there, I do see my new image file. I have created many other tutorials, including how to insert and modify images in Microsoft Word, and how to convert PDFs to PowerPoint slides in Adobe Acrobat. The companion blog post for this video showing all the steps we just performed appears on erinwrightwriting.com along with all my other step-by-step document software tutorials to help you succeed at work and in the classroom. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss future tutorials, and give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.